Notion has released some exciting new updates with some powerful improvements as well as smaller but useful updates. In this video, I wanted to quickly show you all what's new and how you can start using it in your own workspaces. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's dive right in. The first major update that I wanted to share with you all is regarding databases in Notion. One of the difficulties for beginners to start Notion is just the fact that you get this empty page and there's just so many things that you can do with it, and it's really nice to have a starting point for this. So what Notion has done now is that if you type slash database, and let's say I add an inline database here, you can actually already see several templates through the suggested here. So if I click more templates, for example, I can add a tasks tracker and I can choose what kinds of elements I want to add to the task tracker and then click done. So this is a quick and easy way to just really immediately add a useful database to your Notion workspace. It even adds different kinds of views that you can add. So I really think that this is useful for those who want to get started with Notion, but don't quite know what to start with. The other really cool feature is that now if you type slash database, again, if I do inline, I can now do build with AI. So I can ask AI to create my ideal database. So for example, as this one says, if I want to create a customer feedback tracker and then I click enter, it starts designing the database for it. It adds properties, it adds views and all of these things. And here you can customize it. So this is the suggestions that Notion AI created. So I could choose which ones I want to add. I can even add or make changes and then done. So now I have this customer feedback database that's pre-built for me based on AI. So I think this is a really cool use case of AI that's going to save a lot of time. Of course, you might have to still do some edits based on your unique needs, but this just can save so much time thinking about how to do it, adding various views, properties, even small things like changing the icons and the names here is kind of tedious at times. So I think this is something that is going to be really useful. The next update is something I've already actually covered on my channel, but it's about recurring automations. This is a really exciting new update in Notion's automation. So if I type database and I choose inline, I can have an empty database. And now if you click the automation button here, I can actually do this every, which allows me to do every week automations like adding a page here. But not just that, it can also let me send emails every week. So I really like this feature that is now in Notion's automation. If you want a bit more in-depth tutorials on this, I'd recommend you to check out that video that's on my channel. I'll leave a link to it in the top corner over here. The next one is a very useful but small update, and that's regarding the share settings and how things appear here. So when I click share, and now I can see exactly where the access rights are coming from. So I think this is really cool. So I can see that people invited to February updates can also see share settings. So then I can see the hierarchy of where people are being shared to this page. So I really like this new view. It's a lot easier for me to understand what the actual access settings are. You can also check the general access here as well. So be sure to check that out if you're interested in seeing a better view of share settings. The next update I wanted to cover are form updates. These are small but super useful updates to forms that make it even better to use. So the first one is that if you click share form, you'll now see that the access to submission has a can view, which means that respondents can view their own submissions, but not the entire submission list. So before you had to share access to all the submissions there, but now you can only allow them to see their own submission, which is quite nice. The other change is that if you have a question type where respondents can select as many as they like, you can actually set a number here. So if you go to the max selection and you can choose how many they can select, and you can even add a custom here. So that's really cool. This question has to be a multi-select for it to work. So be sure to try that out if you're interested in creating a form with this feature. Next, I wanted to show a really cool button update. So if you type slash button here and I choose button, I can now add a new button that adds blocks to the top of the page and to the bottom of the page. So if I do add block, just as a sample, when the button is clicked, I can now do something like insert blocks. And for example, at the top of the page, and I can type new block added, done. And then if I click here, you can see it here. And I can also do at the bottom of the page, new block added. And if I click here, you can see it at the bottom of the page. So if you have a button somewhere in the middle here, but you actually want to add new items to the top and the bottom, you can now do this. So I think this is a really cool new update so that you're not limited to where you add the button. You can pretty much add it anywhere if you want things to show up on the top and the bottom. The next one is new search features. If you go to the top right hand corner, three dots, you can now search actions. So for example, if I want to change my font style, I could click here. If I'm looking for something like turn into wiki, I can look for it here. So I no longer have to kind of scroll through here with my eyes, but I could actually just type something here to look for things quickly. So the next update is regarding Notion Calendar. This is a super exciting feature, especially if you want to share availability with people. So now you can actually set an expiration date for this availability, which is really useful as it gives you a bit more control over sending availability links, as well as being able to set how far into the future people can actually schedule time with you. So if you haven't really used Notion Calendar much, it is improving bit by bit. So I would highly encourage trying it out. There's a few other small improvements that were sent out in the release notes. Those that I didn't cover in more detail is that automations have errors that show helpful tips now so that it's easier to fix it. And if you are a Jira server / data center user, you can now view previews of links in Notion. The other one is that Android's app inbox, you can now swipe left or right to act on notifications. So if any of these apply to you, be sure to also try those out. Thank you so much for watching. What's your favorite new update? I'd love to hear about it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to add them below, and I hope to see you all in the next video.